one about timing and process. And I'm wondering how you can help us to reconcile that if we are fiscally healthy, our economy is healthy, what is the rush or emergency to do this in this way, to overrule the will of the people and move these funds from trust to reserve? What's the emergency? Why do it that way? Why do it now?
Well, part of the premise of your question, I would argue with, is that we're not overruling the will of the people. We've not eliminated that fund. Now, money from that fund is going into a new fund that we can still, and I would say that the emergency is not necessarily an emergency. I think that you put money back and you save money when you can save money, period. I think that's a good fiscal sense. Now, in this case, what my guess is, the reason why we're dealing with it right now in the special session, is we just, you know, face a revenue shortfall. And it's, you know, $70 million that we're needing to make cuts. We were able to make those cuts in ways that I think are reasonable. I support it 100%. I think that's good government for us to pull that money down. However, I think that illuminates problems. Like, what if we couldn't make those cuts? What if all of a sudden those cuts had to come out of our prisons? What if those cuts had to come out of our K-12 education? What if those cuts had to come out of essential services within Medicaid? Then what do we do? Then how are we doing? We don't have the funds sitting there to do it. And so if we do this, we set up a long-term reserve fund that hopefully will have $250 million in it, not $105 million. Hopefully it'll be really well-funded. Then if we're in a situation where we're hit the mouth with something like that, and we can't make those cuts as smart as what we did, but we actually have to make cuts to essential services, we'll have some of the funds to help bridge that gap until we can replenish those funds.
Follow up, Mr. Speaker.
Yes, Mr. Chair, as we follow up.
Thank you. So if we're not overruling the will of the people, why is the vote requiring 2/3 and not a simple majority?
What I would say is we're not overruling the will of the people. What we're doing is transferring funds. We're not eliminating that fund at all.
Representative Gray, for what purpose?
Question.
You ready to ask your question?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Representative Alger, it's Representative Hamer referenced that the long-term fund is already existence in the interest money from other accounts are going into it. But are you aware that in the language of the bill that we have before us now, we've spent a lot of time, including myself and Noel, talking about the any event of an economic downturn and the triggers that have to be in place to be able to use that. But are you also aware in the bill, and I would assume you are, because you're usually pretty thorough, so we need to address, that the bill also says, or for building two projects. So there can be money spent out of this fund, penny spent out of this fund for economic development projects, even without the calamitous economic triggers that we all put ourselves focus on. Can you reconcile that?
Correct. And it's not new language that's actually in the fund that's already been created, so it's not necessarily in the bill, but it's the language is there because it's there. So it's either way. So it's 3% growth, or if you have a big Amendment 82 project, they can spend the money. Now, this is the thing, I'll tell you that my recommendation to the bill sponsor, and I was hoping to get something done, is to either eliminate the Amendment 82 projects altogether, or make it where we only spend money on the Amendment 82 projects if we have $250 million in the balance. That we never spend the balance less than $250 million. That would be great amendments. And then also, I think 3% growth is too high. We ought to reduce that 3% growth. What we're talking about here are some really good changes. I think your idea of bringing it back to the body is a good idea. That's a good change. Now, all of that would require actually changes to the fund that already exists. That's not before us. So what is presented before us right now is to fund that fund. There is one change that we're going to make into that fund, and that is making it a 2/3 threshold, which was something that was negotiated. So we are making it a little harder to spend money out of that long-term reserve fund, which I think, you know, makes sense that we do that. I would work with you in 2019 to come in and do an amendment to make it even more difficult to spend money out of this, because what I want to see is money that's locked down for a real deal emergency. So I think that's a great idea. The question before us now is, can we trust the governor and can we trust ALC for the next 2 years until we can make other substantial changes to this fund? And that's really what I think I'm focused on. So.